Right now, Pooh Shiesty is one of the hottest rappers in the game. After signing the Gucci Mane's 1017 label in 2020, Pooh became one of hip-hop's rising stars. But all that fame and money doesn't always protect you from the streets, and Pooh has beef with another artist from his hometown of Memphis that has led to robberies, shootings, and several diss tracks. Here's a look at the war in Memphis between Pooh Shiesty and EBG EJizzle. Even though Pooh Shiesty has only been rapping for a few years, he's quickly become one of the most popular in the game as well as one of the wildest. In the short time he's been in the industry, he signed to one of the most respected labels in trap music and collaborated with major artists like Lil Durk and 21 Savage. But he's also made headlines for his involvement in multiple shootings as well as the beef we're about to get into. Shiesty grew up on the south side of Memphis. He's the son of another Memphis rapper who went by the name Mob Boss and founded a local label called Mob Ties Records. Pooh's father was also involved in the streets and did time when the rapper was young. So it seems like the apple doesn't fall far from the tree, and Pooh adapted to his environment growing up in a wild area like South Memphis. Check out our video on the criminal history of Pooh Shiesty for more info on the rapper's background. Despite being a pretty small city, Memphis has one of the highest murder rates in the US and is also known for its high rate of gang activity. Almost every national gang can be found in Memphis, and smaller neighborhood crews are created all the time. Plus, being in the South, it's common for citizens to be strapped with assault weapons, which only adds to the high rate of violence in the city. But Memphis is also known for its great music, from the Memphis Blues to modern-day trap rappers like Yo Gotti, Young Dolph, and now Pooh Shiesty. Memphis has always had a presence in the music industry that's inspired by its authentic culture. So growing up in South Memphis, Shiesty quickly adapted to the streets and built a worldwide name for himself by staying true to his roots. But keeping it real comes at its cost, and while he's been blowing up in the industry, Pooh has been involved in a beef with another Memphis rapper named EBG EJizzle. EBG EJizzle is from North Memphis and reps the Bezel Gang. Shiesty reps the Chopper Gang, which is a crew he started with his childhood friend and frequent collaborator, Big 30. Most fans became aware of this beef after Shiesty dropped the track Back in Blood featuring Lil Durk, which had references to his beef with EBG EJizzle and the Bezel Gang. On the chorus of the track, Pooh raps, "Yeah, you know who took that shit from you, come get it back in blood." This bar is rumored to be a direct taunt to EBG EJizzle over a robbery of some guns that Shiesty and his crew allegedly committed. EJizzle ended up responding with a remix of the track, giving his side of the story. But before we get into the specifics, let's take a deeper look at where this beef started. Pooh Shiesty and EBG weren't always enemies. They both attended Central High School in South Memphis and knew each other before the rapper blew up. But Shiesty and his crew were from South Memphis, while EBG was from the North, two areas that are known to be at war. Before Pooh would get into it with the EBG crew, he started beefing with another North Memphis artist named Big Boogie. Big Boogie is an up-and-coming rapper from the Fraser neighborhood of North Memphis. In July 2020, Big Boogie was interacting with fans on IG Live when he claimed that he was a better rapper than Shiesty. The rap game is pretty competitive, especially in a city as cutthroat as Memphis, and Pooh Shiesty wasn't feeling the disrespect. The rapper and his friend pulled up on Big Boogie's IG Live and confronted him about his comments. The two artists started talking shit to each other for a while. After that, Big Boogie did his own IG Live session not long after, where he claimed there was no real beef between him and Pooh Shiesty because he didn't know him and never met him in real life. He said that he doesn't understand why the rapper has a problem with him because they don't know each other like that. But Shiesty ignored his comment and continued to taunt Big Boogie on social media. He said that he tried to confront him in his own neighborhood and Boogie just ran away scared. To take the disrespect even further, Shiesty created his own brand of weed called Red Rum, which is the name of Big Boogie's crew. That way he could say he was smoking on Red Rum and really mean it. The two rappers went back and forth on social media after that, leading Big Boogie to eventually drop a diss track called Big R4L. Not long after, the rapper was performing in Mississippi when his concert was shot up. More than 50 shots were fired from 5 different weapons and left 2 people dead. Boogie's good friend Jasmine was one of the victims and happened to be on stage with him when the shooting took place. At first, many fans thought that the shooting was retaliation from Pooh Shiesty for the diss track Boogie had recorded. But a few days after the shooting, Shiesty went on his IG Live and told fans that he had nothing to do with the shooting and that their issue wasn't that deep. He may have been lying, but it does seem pretty extreme to shoot 50 rounds and kill 2 people just over some internet beef. Since then, both rappers stopped dissing each other on social media. Big Boogie is signed to CMG, Yo Gotti's label. Moneybag Yo is also signed to CMG, who signed Pooh Shiesty's right-hand man Big 30 to his imprint in 2019. So it seems like the beef would have gotten in the way of business and things went any further. But just because Pooh Shiesty was no longer beefing with Big Boogie, doesn't mean his issues with rappers from North Memphis were over. On November 6, 2020, Shiesty and Lil Durk dropped the audio for the song Back in Blood. Even though Pooh Shiesty was well known in Memphis, this is the track that got him more recognition from mainstream audiences. Sadly, the day the song was released was also the day that King Von would be killed in Atlanta after a fight with rapper Quando Rondo. Back in Blood shot up the charts, even though they hadn't released the official video. It became one of the hottest songs of late 2020, racking up hundreds of millions of streams on Spotify and Apple Music. Then a few weeks later, Shiesty posted a message at 6 a.m. that had fans nervous about what was gonna happen next. Post read, "Drop that song, you ain't gonna live to see that baby get here." Then, on New Year's Day 2021, two rappers from EBG, EJizzle and Moose Slime, released a track called Back in Blood Remix, where they gave their version of events that Shiesty raps about on the original track. In the video, they're even rocking CGK hoodies, which stands for Chopper Gang Killer. The crazy thing is that EBG EJizzle wasn't even really a rapper to begin with, he just didn't want Pooh Shiesty to get away with spreading lies just because he's a popular artist. Pooh took to social media to tell his ops that they made a huge mistake by dropping the track and that he did 18 million views before he even mentioned their names. Right after that, they dropped a music video for Back in Blood that had already been filmed in Chicago, and the song became even more popular. EBG's Back in Blood remix was taken down due to copyright infringement, so EJizzle dropped another Pooh Shiesty diss track called Rumors, which quickly did major numbers. The video even featured a part with Quando Rondo, who shone on a FaceTime call with EJizzle. This was a direct diss to Lil Durk, as his close friend King Von was killed by a member of Rondo's crew back in November. A few days after the remix was dropped, EBG EJizzle and Moose Slime did an interview with Street Juice TV and confirmed that Back in Blood was a direct diss at them. They said that Pooh Shiesty is all cap and that he doesn't actually live the life he raps about. They said that he's from the nice part of town, while they're from the gutter, and Shiesty's just mad that his ops live the life he wants to portray. They also said that he's just trying to beef with any rapper he can from North Memphis to keep up his gangster image. In the interview, he also broke down the robbery that Shiesty rapped about. He says that Shiesty and his crew broke into one of their spots and stole some guns. He says that no one was home at the time and they didn't get anything major, but on the song, he made it seem like it was some big time robbery and extortion when it really wasn't that serious. Plus, he also dissed one of their dead EBG brothers. EJizzle also claimed that Shiesty was the one who had their remix taken off of YouTube because he couldn't handle the competition. When asked about putting Quando Rondo in the video, EJizzle admits that he has no real problems with Durk, he just got himself caught up in the beef for co-signing Pooh Shiesty and being featured on the track. EJizzle says he was forced to set the record straight and let his side of the story be known, so it didn't seem like he was willing to let the rapper disrespect his crew just because he's the more popular artist. Not long after the interview was released, Shiesty started posting clips to his social media that suggested something had happened to one of his ops. The rapper posted a slide to his story that said, "Damn, that pussy dissed, now he can't even walk," with crying emoji. He followed up with another message that said, "Walk, I don't even think bro talking. Where he disappeared to? You okay? Check in, give me some," with more crying emojis. He continued to diss saying, "Y'all ain't gonna put that in the next song, is it? And the ugly main one rapping, not the other kid, he next." Rumors started going around the internet that EBG EJizzle had been shot and paralyzed, but the rapper then came forward to tell what really happened. He had been shot in the arm 3 times and had to wear a cast, but he wasn't exactly paralyzed. He was back on the streets just a few days later and released yet another diss track called Paralyzed, where he makes it clear that the shooting isn't gonna slow down the beef. On the track, he throws shade at Shiesty's brother for allegedly being a snitch and claims that the rapper is just an internet gangster. He drops the bar, "You had a clear shot on my face and still went for my arm," suggesting that either Shiesty or one of his Chopper Gang affiliates shot him just for the clout, but didn't have the guts to go for the kill shot. But on the same day that Paralyzed dropped, Shiesty received some tragic news, that his brother, another up-and-coming rapper named T2P, passed away after losing a battle with brain cancer. After that, Shiesty had to cancel a few shows and spend time with his family, so he didn't have time to respond to the beef in his music. Since then, neither rapper has released any more diss tracks, and the beef seems to have calmed down for now, but that doesn't mean things can't pop off again at any moment. Pooh Shiesty still fighting the case in Bay Harbor Islands, Florida, where 2 men were shot following some kind of drug or sneaker sale gone wrong. Plus, just recently, the rapper was involved in another crazy incident where he allegedly shot up a club in Miami after getting robbed of $40,000. During the shooting, 20 people were hit and 2 ended up dying. Footage from the scene shows the rapper realizing that he got jacked and several gunshots could be heard. More footage of the rapper leaving the club after the shots were fired shows him clearly trying to conceal a weapon as he walks out. It's still not clear exactly what happened, but it's definitely not good for Shiesty's legal situation. At least in the first shooting, no one ended up dead, but when 20 people get shot and 2 end up dead in a crowded nightclub with it all on video footage, someone's going to jail. It's possible that Pooh wasn't the one who actually fired the shots and he just had a strap ready to protect himself, but he's clearly involved and it'll make proving his innocence in the other shooting a bit harder, especially when he keeps getting himself involved in crazier situations. Pooh took to social media to claim that the rumors that he got robbed were all cap, posting an IG story with the caption, "False allegations, nothing never been took from me." Shiesty may be lying to protect his image, or it's possible that not all the facts have come to light. As things progress, more information should come out about the case and Shiesty's legal situation. Hopefully, this will force the rapper to lay low and focus on his music rather than the violence in the streets. But it seems like Pooh Shiesty is one of those rappers who loves the beef too much to leave it alone for good.